Butch David shoots. He scores! What a shot by Butch David! And the Blues lead 2-1. Comes O'Reilly back in. O'Reilly waiting. Now for Barbashev. Wide open. Shoots. He scores! Barbashev! And it's 4-1. Today in game two of the homestand, the focus turns back to the Central and a matchup against their longtime rival, the Dallas Stars. Can the Blues keep the good times rolling here at home? Find out next. Welcome the Dallas Stars to town for a matinee as the homestand continues. And hi again and good afternoon, everyone. I'm John Kelly alongside my partner, Darren Pang. And Darren, this is fun here at home. The Blues haven't lost in regulation in their last 11 games at Enterprise Center.
Yeah, it has been. And even when they've started games out slowly, like the last one against Washington, John, they were able to get traction and make their adjustments and get playing their game as well. And I got to believe, and Bernie was talking about in the pregame show, having a capacity crowd and the energy of this building really gives you a boost when you're down and out, or seemingly so.
Yeah, no question. It doesn't hurt to have the pairing of Krug and Falk. Darren, of course, Krug scored the game-tying goal. They were combined plus +7 the other night.
They've been a terrific tandem. I mean, obviously, big adjustments, and Andy Strickland talked about that in the pregame show, coming from the East. Both incredibly great hockey sense by both of them. They're a good matchup tandem as well, and it depends on who the matchup is. If it's a big, burly matchup, you often see that with Mikkola and with Parayko, but if it's a speedier hockey sense line that the matchup against, both Falk and Krug have no problems going up against that.
Darren, what did you think of the newly formed line of O'Reilly with Buchnevich and Barbashev the other night?
Pretty darn good. I mean, I like the change. I like what Craig Berube has done. I think he's been masterful at little tweaks. So here's where they're at. I mean, 3 goals, 3 assists. They're +7 at even strength. Even strength shots, 6. Even strength slot shots, 4. Those of the most dangerous variety, as we well know. And get into the inner slot, getting close to the net, as Barbashev does right there. And then obviously Ryan O'Reilly, I thought he was moving the puck impeccably well during the course of the game, and he's got 2 wingers that'll go get pucks. I mean, they combine speed and they combine tenacity, just like Buchnevich does right here, and makes a terrific play back to Ryan O'Reilly, who again, so good with his stick, lifting sticks, buying time for the next guy that's going to make a play. And so, I mean, all in all, there's a reason why Craig Berube did not change the lines from the last game against Washington. It's because it's been successful. And empty net goal for Buchnevich, just a icing on the cake right there. But I like what I've seen so far, and it's plenty deep right now.
Yeah, no question. Meanwhile, the Dallas Stars, they actually played yesterday afternoon at home in Big D, and they came from behind and beat Pittsburgh 3-2. But Darren, they're great at home. They have 13 wins on the road, only 4 wins.
Well, they've got to pick that part of their game up. Even in yesterday afternoon's game, I mean, down in the game, gave up the first 2 goals. But they're a very resilient group, and we all know it's a good rivalry. But the top line of Robertson, Roope Hintz, Joe Pavelski has been dynamic. That's our Plaza Tire Service storyline, and it's a good one. And the Blues better be ready for basically a real heavy forecheck. They're big bodies. They're strong. They're going to go through you. In back-to-back games, you hope that the Blues can take advantage of that.
It's the fourth and final game of the regular season between these long-time rivals. So far, the Blues have won 2 of 3. And the first 3 games have seen 131 total hits. Will it be physical again today? Find out next. St. Louis Blues Hockey is presented in part by Dobbs Tire and Auto Centers. With 42 locations all over town, expert tire and auto care is always close by. Chevrolet, the number one selling vehicle in the St. Louis area. Find yours at your Mid-America Chevy dealer. Well, a great day for hockey in St. Louis as the Blues continue their 5-game homestand after a win against the Caps. Today, it's the Dallas Stars.
And our Dobbs starting goaltenders, Jordan Binnington, his last start Wednesday, a 5-3 loss in Pittsburgh. He goes against the Saskatchewan native, Braden Holtby. He won his last start a couple of days ago against Florida, a 6-5 shootout victory. And for Craig Berube's Blues, it is Saad, Sundquist, and David Perron against Glendening, Foxa, and Michael Roffel, the Stars' checking line. Puck in the blue zone, and now grabbed by Bortuzzo. On defense with Scandella. And the Blues come in, but they are offside at the Dallas blue line.
And Jamie Benn, captain of the Dallas Stars, jumps onto the ice as we take a look at Craig Berube, who's done a phenomenal job. Last eight games against Dallas, the Blues are 6-1-1, but he knows that the Dallas Stars will get close to the net. They're great at deflections. They lead the league in that area. And for Rick Bowness, certainly trailing 2-0 against Pittsburgh on home ice and winning 3-2, that is a momentum builder for the Dallas Stars.
After losing five in a row, Darren, they have won their last four. And of course, they had that long pause where they did not play any games. A 17-day pause. Now it's Jamie Benn in. 2-on-1. Benn a shot. And a good save by Binnington with his right pad, and the Blues fly the other way. Thomas and Shen. Thomas. And a good play by Heiskanen to get back to break it up. And up and down we go. And a pass for Gurionov. He wears number 34. Really never tipped it. And that is an icing call against the Stars.
Big conversation there going on in front of the Dallas Stars bench. But here's Jamie Benn going down the right side, lets this one through and basically gave it away by the way he turned his hand over. So that's why Binnington was able to get that pad flushed down to the ice. And on a potential 2-on-1 break, although Heiskanen does a great job right there on that little heel-to-toe saucer pass that Thomas was trying to get to Shen.
Again, no Tarasenko, Prunovic, or Wallman, all in COVID protocol. Faceoff Barbashev and Tyler Seguin. Dallas, the second best faceoff team in the league. Over 55% this season. And 52.5% against the Blues in three games. It's Parayko back to the Blues. For his partner Mikula. Now Barbashev, who's red hot as he comes in. 9 points in his last six games. And tracked down by the captain O'Reilly. Now Barbashev trying to get free. A shot by O'Reilly. That was blocked, I believe, by Heiskanen. Now it's slid back of the goal. And Roope Hintz, who had the winner yesterday, gets it to center. That's off Parayko and now settled by Barbashev.
Yeah, Robertson was flying through the neutral zone there, but a good work there by Parayko as he uses his boot to block that potential pass. And in the meantime, time this afternoon for a Toyota Keys to the Game, and you got to have a heavy forecheck. I mean, the D of the Dallas Stars are good, they're solid, they're big, and they can move the puck out of the zone. And the wingers need to be in the shooting lanes in the blue zone because of the way that the Dallas Stars defensemen can walk the line and change angles, like Klingberg right here.
And a pass by Klingberg in front, big rebound, and settled by Parayko. Yeah. And then Binnington bumped a bit.
But how many times do we see the Dallas Stars defenseman walk the line, get a little wrister, the wingers aren't paying attention, and the puck gets through, and there's danger.
Now the Blues coming back. Logan Brown a shot. That's on goal. Saved there by Holtby. It's really amazing, Darren, with the likes of Heiskanen and Klingberg, the Dallas defense has combined for only 9 goals this year.
Yeah, very surprising. The Blues have 20 with their defensemen, and I think they're getting hotter. I love the way the Blues D are playing. I like the way they're boxing out. I like the way they're protecting their goaltender.
Now Logan Brown for Bozak. He looks around, now spins around. Cost it in the slot. He'll drop it back. Wide open Scandella. Wrist shot. That goes wide of Holtby. And now picked up by the Russian Gurionov. And that's dumped in. Scandella has a couple of Stars all over him. In front, Costin, second chance, and he clears it off the far boards and back down. Now Yanni Hakanpää, big finish defenseman, was drafted by the Blues. Here's Falk, steers it around. Now Costin back, and the Stars keep it alive. And picked up by the former Flyer, Roffel, for Foxa. Runs into Shen. At the line, though, Glendening a shot, and that goes wide of Binnington. And now Robert Thomas coming off a 2-assist game against the Capitals. That's his eighth multi-assist game of the year for Robert Thomas. Broken up by Thomas. Now Kyrou, he flies in to the net. A shot and a stick save by Holtby. And Kyrou's first chance as he flew down the right wing side.
And Dallas defensively got to pick their poison. Which team are they going to, which line are they going to match up against? It looks like they picked Kyrou and Thomas as the main matchup line for the defensive line led by Foxa.
Now it is Shen, and his pass blocked. Then hits the other way. Long dumping. That comes around Joe Pavelski.
Oh!
And on goal. Tip maybe. And a right pad save by Binnington.
Yeah, that was a nifty tip there by Hintz.
Now the Blues back. Here's Thomas. Drops it off. Intended for Kyrou. A stick was there in the lane to break it up. 4 minutes gone in the first period.
Yeah, Thomas line going for a change. Fresh bodies on the ice.
Including David Perron. Now for Saad. And he was stripped of the puck. And now getting back is Oscar Sundqvist, who scored his second of the year the other night. Long pass by Krug for Perron into Sundqvist. And he was rolled off the puck by Kivi Ranta. Blues get it back at center and then flipped in by Falk. Blues have won 2 of 3 this year against Dallas. All three games by the same 4-1 score. That's knocked down the ice and now settled by Falk. And then Sundqvist, late on his shift, he'll drop it off.
Boy, I love the way Falk passes the puck. I mean, nice and firm, and there's no softness about the way he moves that puck.
And now the Minnesota native gets it again. Long bouncing dump in, but he was on his own side of center, and that's an icing call.
Yeah, a little debate there whether or not Falk's clear was an icing or not, and I believe they are going to move it to center ice. It was the wrong call. And here's Klingberg on the left side. Buchnevich gets his stick in the lane. How many times have we heard Craig Berube talk about how smart, how detail-oriented Buchnevich is? And Buchnevich has been a bit of a Swiss Army knife here for the Blues, John. I mean, power play, penalty kill, good 5-on-5 matchups, and having a great offensive year.
Yeah, 13 goals. There's a shot tip. That's Scandella, let it go. Just missed Holtby. Now centered, and that went by O'Reilly all the way down. In addition, Buchnevich now plus 17, second best on the team, and 11th best in the entire NHL. Scandella's pass. That's off a stick and down.
Yeah, Barbashev, Buchnevich, and Kyrou all with 13. Trail Vladdy Tarasenko, still not in the lineup. He leads with 14 goals.
As Binnington wanders, puts it on the wall. Cut off there by Radek Foxa. At the line for Heiskanen. Fires it up high, and that goes over the Blues goal. And now it is O'Reilly back for Barbashev. He is eyed by a couple of stars. Spun ahead by Parayko. Now Mikola to center and dumped in by Buchnevich. And he goes off on a line change. Now Foxa for Robertson. Had a 3-assist game yesterday against Pittsburgh. As the end of the Penguins' 10-game winning streak. Now Falk for Bozak. And the Blues get it near the line, but not out. Kept in by Pavelski. And now Hintz back on the goal.
Oh, Binnington has no goal stick.
And now he gets it back from Krug. Good play. Here's Heiskanen around a Suter. And he walks in the better and a shot on goal. And a save by Binnington. He doesn't have the stick, though. It's near his goal crease as the Stars swarm the net. Robertson in front for Hintz. Backhander. And that goes wide. The Blues are trying to get Binnington a stick, and now they finally do, and they get it out. And now the Blues at the line. Clem Costin, and he delays a bit.
That's a pretty good line change there by Rick Bowness on the road, John, because he got his number one line up against the fourth line of the Blues, including, you know, young wingers like Logan Brown and Costin, even though you got the veteran in the middle in Bozak.
Shots now 4-2 for Dallas. Here's the veteran Radulov in there. And picked away from him by Kyrou. And now Parayko near the Stars line. That's broken up. Long pass for Kivi Ranta. And he flies in. Long shot. Glove save by Binnington. And no rebound. So a good pace early in this matinee from Chili St. Louis.
Points. It's just been a breakout year offensively for Barbashev, and he is part of our Kia player profile, one shy of his career high. And Look at the shooting percentage. I mean, you talk about efficiency. Tied for sixth best in the NHL. 49 blue. Look at this little redirection right here. And Holtby's sliding over to his right. That's where the puck was intended, but that just that little redirection, good hands, and it just misses to the glove side on Holtby.
Now Sundqvist on the faceoff against Ben. Scramble draw comes back to Parayko. Blues at home this year, 13-3-2. Dallas on the road, 4-9-1. Holtby out of the net. Now for Esa Lindell. Off the boards and out now for Ben. He'll bang it in. And Mikkola back first. For Parayko, now around to David Perron. And Perron gets one to center ice. Little self-chip there. That's steered away by Klingberg and back into Blues territory. And they're going to rule that Parayko could have played that. And they wave it off at the last second. Long stretch pass. Now for Perron. He'll drop it off for Barbashev. In front for O'Reilly. Off his tape. And now the Blues captain gets it back. Here's Crew. Funnels it all the way around to his partner, Falk. And now back to Crew. Takes the hit. Long shot by Brown in front. And that rolls around off bodies. At the line again. Another shot up high by Buchnevich, and it goes out of play, and the Blues want delay of game.
And they're going to get it. And Holtby's probably taking a little responsibility for that because that long shot went off his chest protector, and normally Holtby, who's got very good hands, wouldn't allow.
Minor penalty. Delay of game.
Wouldn't allow that puck to squirt out like that, and that's what results in that puck over the boards. Here's a quick shot by Buchnevich. There's the rebound there, and that, yeah, I could see Holtby afterwards looking at Heiskanen and kind of taking the blame on that one, knowing that if he would have got that with his glove, that play would never have happened.
And the Blues power play ranked third in the league, 29.6%. Here's Krug for Perron. He waits, now shoots it on goal, and a save. And of course, the Blues power play, sponsored by the Gateway Honda Dealers, who will donate $500 for each goal, helping grant the wishes of critically ill children. Blues are 4-for-13 against Dallas this year. They win it back now for Crew, for Shen. Now Crew fires it up high, stick saved by Holtby, and the rebound is banged all the way down the ice.
Kind of had that double eye formation in front for the screen, both Brandon Saad and Ryan O'Reilly, and that's what told Crew, got to get that puck at the net.
Now Saad trying to work in, tops on the Blues with 5 power play goals. And the Stars play it off the glass and back down.
How about Torrey Krug? His first 20 games, he had 10 points. In his last 10, he's got 3 goals and 6 assists.
More and more comfortable every month with the Blues. Now it's Justin Falk. For Shen. Back to Falk. On for Perron. And his pass blocked and tipped ahead by Foxa. And the Blues have to reload, and now an errant pass. And Darren, remember in the first meeting, that 4-1 Dallas win, the Stars got 2 shorthanded goals against the Blues. That was the story of the game.
Yeah, it sure was. Roffel and Hintz were dynamic in that area.
Now Barbashev ahead. Buchnevich, he'll drop it, but Robert Thomas blew a tire. And now Ben comes back. 1-on-2. And the veteran just kills some clock. Sekera with it to the net. That was blocked and tipped by Barbashev.
If you would have seen Glendening earlier, Glendening was in all alone.
Now 25 to go in the Heiskanen minor. So far, nothing doing in the power play. Walked in by Buchnevich, trying to get to the middle. Suter there, and a weak clear, knocked down by Thomas. And now it's picked up by Roffel. He gets it out, but he was checked by Kyrou, who throws it back in the zone. And now lobbed ahead by Hakanpää. That's blocked by Parayko. And the big guy comes back in. He goes wide. Now to the net. Big rebound. And a shot by Brown right on goal. And a save by Holtby. On Logan Brown, the Blues only 1 power play shot. It's still scoreless. Score here. Sorry, Darren. The Blues have had 17 players in COVID. And, of course, Mike Van Ryan just out of COVID. And now Ray Birilli, the Blues head trainer, is in COVID protocol. So Dusty Flynn takes over. Darren, Ray has never missed a regular season game in the NHL until today. So Ray said he's feeling good. And hopefully he's back soon.
Yeah, he's going to take advantage of that rest right there for sure. And There's a former Blue, number 19. There's Scott Mellenby up there with Doug Armstrong. Packed house here this afternoon. Great stuff. Yeah, it's odd during the warm-up not seeing Ray right here to my right. He's a fixture.
So get well soon, Ray, although, as he said, he is feeling well. As now the Blues, Buchnevich at center ice.
It's time to stop testing, John.
Well, a lot of people agree with that.
Yep.
And now Mikola tipped near the line. And now Roope Hintz back. And bobbled and cleared by Parayko. Now ahead for O'Reilly, but the Blues are offside. Barbashev could not keep his skate on the line.
That's a great pass by Buchnevich right here to my right. I mean, it's just so impressive when you get to ice level here and you see how quick the game develops and how they've got to put that pass right on the tape and in constant motion. And you can see that, you know, Ryan O'Reilly and all good centermen, all good players do that. Get the puck and get the blue line. Reach out there, and then you can make a play once you get the blue line. But that was just barely offside by Barbashev on the other side of the ice.
Now it comes in front. No one is there except Haskinen. Really good young defenseman drafted. Third overall back in 17. Tipped by Koskin down the ice.
So you don't always need the number one overall pick to change around a franchise. Those number threes have proven to be pretty good around the NHL.
Yeah, I would say. Now it is Haskinen again. Little soft chip in there. Radulov trying to get away from Scandella. Then picked up by Bortuzzo. Koskin, and he gets it near the line. Second chance, he muscles the way to his way to center ice. And that's now heads off.
That's a good battle right there by Koskin. And he and Radulov bang while they go for a change. Not a whole lot of sustained pressure either way so far. Kind of a feeling out process, it looks like.
Here's Falk's pass to center. Sundqvist now for Perron. Now the Blues play the dump and chase game. Hawk and Pop back to get it. He plays it around. Ben is in the area. Good play. Now ahead for Gurionov off his stick and recovered by the Blues. Here's Crew trying to hit Sundqvist. And then Saad gloves it down. Couldn't handle it. Checked by Foxa and moved ahead now by Andre Sakura.
And before he dumped that puck in, Krug had already peeled off going to the corner anticipating it.
That's kept in by the Stars and a shot by Glendening is up high as that was barely kept in. Then a raffle. Worked over by Saad. Nearly a hooking miner there by Saad. And now it's grabbed by Sundqvist. And he gets it on to center ice. Under 7 to play in the opening period. Shot 6-5 for the Blues. And Lindell's pass. Tipped at center. And a delayed offside. Now grabbed by John Klingberg, who will be a UFA at the end of the year. Now the Blues at center. Shen. He was stripped of the puck. Robertson back in for Hintz. He goes wide. Now back in front. And that's broken up by Scandella. And the Blues get it out with Jordan Kyrou. He comes in around Lindell, drops it. Thomas shoots it on goal. And a save by Holpe. What a setup there. And Robert Thomas had a great chance.
Yeah, strong stick there by Jordan Kyrou as he crossed the blue line. He had to use his stick, let the puck alone, and get the basically the stick play. Oh, look out.
Robertson back in, trying to dangle around Thomas. But then Mikola got back to break it up. And now it's Kyrou at his own line. Good stick handling there.
Kyrou's putting on a bit of a show here.
Now picked up by Peterson. Into the zone, Kiviranta back to Peterson. And that's off the pad of Binnington, no problem. And now settled by Thomas for Crew. And he's forced back in the blue zone. And now Falk with it. He'll play one back to his partner. Again, they were a combined plus 7 on Friday night. As the Blues get it to center, Buchnevich. Here's O'Reilly. Runs into the linesman. And the Blues have to delay that entry. Now they do get in with Buchnevich. For Bortuzzo. Waiting. Shoots it off a body and then maybe off O'Reilly and just wide. And O'Reilly gets it. No one is home on the right point. And Buchnevich has to go all the way back in his own zone.
Pretty close call there on the near side.
Now a pass ahead. It's Bortuzzo again. Sometimes good things happen when you put the puck on net. And back of the goal, O'Reilly finds Bertuzzo. He's wide open. That shot off a body. O'Reilly there. And he was checked by Hakanpää. And back to center ice. And then floated back in by Bertuzzo. And it comes to Sekera, number five, for Hakanpää. Dallas, a very good defensive team. And now they have their checking line out here. Glendening coming in. Worked over by Parayko. And Glendening, the former Red Wing, goes down. Mikkola trying to move it. Snared by Foxa. And around back again, Mikkola there. And that was kept in by Foxa, not for long. Saad gets it out. Now tipped by Perron. And he's got a partial break. And he lost the handle. Caught from behind by Sekera. And now we get a whistle. And Holtby has lost his goalie mask. So we get the mask. Or we get the whistle, rather, as he gets his mask. Good save by Holtby earlier on Robert Thomas.
Keep your home arena warm.
Kyrus and Robertson, the good things happen when they've got the puck. And Robertson made the great play yesterday afternoon just to get the puck on net. And Joe Pavelski ended up scoring the goal. And that gave Dallas some life and a come-from-behind win.
Yeah, again, three assists in that victory. As they scored a couple of goals late, the winner with 3:46 to go, as Darren mentioned, ending the Penguins' 10-game winning streak. Now the Blues to center. Here's Robert Thomas. Throws one low.
Yeah, tough one there. They both entered about a foot and a half together as they entered the right side. There's not much room to make a play.
Puck in front. And now the Stars get it free. Gurionov trying to walk around Falk. And dumped in. Binnington sets it up for Parayko in this scoreless first period. And then Kyrou, look out, he was drilled by Ben. Got caught looking at the puck and was hit hard. But Kyrou back on his skates and he goes off. No Suter's pass. And at the St. Louis line, that was knocked down by Kostin. Parayko high flip out. And now picked up by Bozak. Mikkola for Parayko. Here comes Bozak with speed. And that was thrown down by the goaltender Holtby. Former Cup winner with Washington. This goes down the ice. Scandella back there against Glendening. And then Logan Brown comes in. Foxa trying to pry it free. Back for Suter. Suter a wrist shot. Off bodies in front, and a big scrum in front, and knocked away by Bozak. And settled, and cleared by Kostin. Who's trying to make a line change. It's Raffel back in there, spinning around. And then Barbashev now in front for Falk.
That last scrum in front of the net, John, was a real good example of the Blues defensemen just not worrying about that puck being at their feet, but turning around and boxing out and getting their sticks and making sure that they tie up sticks in front. And they've worked hard at that in practice, and especially against a team like this, the Dallas Stars, who are so good and close.
Now back at the line, and Falk rolls it low. And O'Reilly back for Falk. His partner's wide open, Krug. His shot blocked out high by Kivi Ranta. Yeah.
Kivi Ranta's really filled up that fourth line role pretty nicely. That was a good block right there.
And now the Blues will jam it back in on a delayed offside with 80 seconds left in the first period. Hakanpää pass ahead. Lindell to center. And then Mikkola back to the line. And that's an offside.
Well, Jordan Kyrou knew that his two line mates were making a change, so he's got to get the puck out of the zone, number one. He spins there, and then he goes, oh, okay, let's get it out of the zone. Now I'll play it back. And as he had his head down playing it back, here comes Ben. He was probably looking at Pavelski because his eyes were straight ahead. Likely didn't see Jamie Benn in the peripheral vision before he got hit. And yeah, it was a... Something happened when Kostin came by to my left. He fell down, lost his balance, was holding his hand. He kept looking back at the Dallas bench. And I like when he gets that way and plays aggressively.
1 minute to play.
Under a minute to go here in the first period. Now Saad in there against Ben. Comes free. Sundqvist, a pass back. And that was tipped down the ice by Robertson, who played his junior hockey with Niagara in the Ontario Hockey League. That comes around. And now the Blues back of the goal. Perron and Ben, they go down. Sundquist. And he's forced back to the corner. And around for Parayko. And off the boards and out. Just not a lot of room on the ice at this point. Now Ben back in there. Trying to walk around Nikola. Backhander on goal. Save. Binnington. Rebound. Ben again. And Binnington got over. Here's Klingberg waiting. Now Robertson. And that's broken up by the Blues. With 10 to go in the period. And now Perron. He comes in with Shen. And then the late man Krug. He'll race to the puck. And a centering pass blocked. And that will do it. So a scoreless first period. A big hit from Jamie Benn late. We saw Costin get angry.
And we'll stop it right here. Right here is what happened on that line change. And I was blocked out a little bit right there. Just a little whack on the left hand or the arm. And Costin goes down. And it didn't look that bad when it happened right there. But it caught him right in the wrist area by the cuff. Another discreet play by Jamie Benn.
Got away with it. At least this time. So after one in St. Louis, in this matinee, the shots 10-7 in favor of the St. Louis Blues. As the Blues and Stars wrap up their regular season series in St. Louis, no score after one. Toyota takes you. Test drive one today. Toyota, let's go places. The Blues outshoot the Stars 10-7, but the goaltenders were perfect. So we head to the second scoreless. John Kelly upstairs, and Darren Pang is down between the benches. And Dallas comes in here, Darren Pang. And they try to, as you like to say, get in the kitchen, rattle some pans, right, as you like to say?
I sure do. And they certainly one guy has done that to start this hockey game, and I think it's important to nullify him. I mean, we've seen Jamie come into this building before. We've seen him so many times with this rivalry between, you know, Dallas and the St. Louis Blues. So a little subtle, little whack on the wrist on Costin trying to get into his kitchen there. He follows through on a hit with Mikkola, and then he's going to just grab on a little bit. Then as you're... Got that grin on his face just to irk you a little bit more. But he's when he's on his game, there's very few that are as powerful. He finishes his checks. He can make good plays. And again, it's a player that I think the Blues have got to nullify as this game goes along.
By the way, happy 11th birthday to Chloe Strickland. Of course, the lovely daughter of our reporter, Andy Strickland. Chloe turns 11 tomorrow. So happy birthday, Chloe.
Happy birthday, Chloe. Good stuff.
Hopefully the Blues can get you an early birthday gift with a win today. Underway in the second, team's at full strength. Now Mikkola at the line. Trying to make a pass, Stars with it. Robertson's feed. That goes just wide of Binnington, so that is an icing call.
Pretty good judgment there by Binnington. He's got his pad sealed against the post, and that just barely goes wide.
Darren, by the way, we mentioned Dallas's comeback yesterday. It was an NHL first yesterday. The first time a team has picked up a regulation win to halt a double-digit winning streak after trailing in the last 10 minutes of regulation. First time ever in NHL history.
That's amazing. Amazing stat there.
Yeah, NHL put it out today, and I thought it was... I know it's rather esoteric, but obviously it's something that had never happened before. Now the Stars back in. Roberts into the net. Save Binnington. It's loose there. And he makes a couple of saves in the puck in the goal crease. And covered by the Blues goaltender.
Ooh, that's what makes it difficult against this Joe Pavelski line. Is they will not fade away from that blue paint. They're going to hang around and hang around. That's why you've got to tie up sticks in front. Make sure that Pavelski in particular doesn't get a hold of him. Terrific passing play by all three forwards of the Dallas Stars. And a great save to nullify it all by goaltender Jordan Binnington. You can see Krug gets in behind him there. He's going to be the goaltender on the goal line. But again, Joe Pavelski having another phenomenal season.
And right off the faceoff, the Stars a chance. And now it's covered. Dallas winning 57% or 67% of the draws in the first period. As we said, They are number two in the league in the faceoff department.
A little confusion as to who
number
the penalty's on.
Number 77 in St. Louis, minor penalty, hooking.
Hooking call there. At one point, I thought I saw Gerionov, the forward for the Dallas Stars, number 34, put his hands up. I'd actually thought that puck went in the net as well on the stick side. Right there. That's where he put the hands up right there. Oh, yeah, and there's the stick of Mikkola helped out. You can see Sagan has actually got it locked in there, too. He's going to make sure right about here that he's going to keep that arm there. There we go. We're going to keep it over top of it. And just enough time for that referee to see that.
So the Stars, their first power play of the afternoon. And Joe Pavelski sends it back for Klingberg. A shot off bodies in front, maybe off of Bertuzzo. Now Hintz to this side to Klingberg, to the veteran Pavelski. Good stick there by Sundquist to break it up. And it goes all the way down the ice. Dallas fifth best in the power play, 26.7%. 1-for-8 against the Blues in three games. Meanwhile, the Blues have killed 17 in a row on home ice. Now Pavelski lost it in his skates and cleared up the middle by Falk.
I love what Jim Montgomery has done with this penalty kill unit. And boy, does he ever use a plethora of forwards as well, including, you know, Robert Thomas getting so much experience there. Buchnevich has been so good on the penalty kill to go along with the veterans that have been mainstays.
Well, Sagan in the corner. Here's Robertson back out to the line. Suter now for Ben. Suter, a shot, got through. Saved by Binnington. Rebound and chipped away by Buchnevich.
Just at the last second, too. Good stick by Buchnevich.
Now 45 to go in the power play. Stars turn it over. And Buchnevich for Thomas. And they come in 2-on-2. Thomas going wide. Now spinning on Haskinen. Bertuzzo comes in. And it's knocked down. And now Ben is away for Dallas. And a break with Haskinen. Great play by Scandella to knock it away. And now the Blues have a break the other way. And Buchnevich. And a backhander. And that's handled by Holtby, who throws it down.
That's a long shift by Buchnevich. A minute and 22 seconds. And a good burst of energy at the very end of it.
Now 10 to go in the Mikkola minor. And a good kill by the Blues as it's cleared by Bertuzzo. So both clubs are 0-for-1. Dallas one power play shot. It's Haskinen from the angle. That shot a mile high. Comes around, tipped along by Mikkola. Well, Suter turns it the other way. Here comes Robertson back in for Dallas. And then he gets his stick up on Scandella, who checks for blood. Play continues. Held in there by Haskinen. Now gloved down by Scandella. And then David Perron for Parayko. Look out. Ooh, almost had his pocket picked there by Robertson. It goes down the ice for an icing call.
Well, the coaching staff of the Blues maybe not happy with that icing call right there, but here's that 2-on-1 break and a great play by Scandella after Robert Bertuzzo. He was in the offensive zone looking for a pass. It rolled off his stick and the Dallas Stars countered the other way, and this was at the tail end of the shift. And Buchnevich, here's the save by Jordan Binnington on a redirection in front by Jason Robertson. Good hand-eye coordination, and it's another reason why the Dallas Stars are one of the best tips and deflection team in the NHL. 22% of their goals have been deflections or tips, John.
They go to the net. And I bet a lot of those by Pavelski. Maybe the best in the league. At age 37. Now Scandella around. Perron in the area. Kept in by Klingberg in front. And a wide open net. Fox had never tipped it.
Did Parayko get his stick up at the last second? I think he did.
Yeah, he may have lifted the stick, but was he wide open? And the Blues off the glass and kept in by Klingberg. This is Raffel. And now Parayko trying to get it back. Raffel in there, creating all kinds of havoc. And now Raffel lost his hockey stick. Klingberg a shot. That goes wide. Lindell from the other side. Pressure by Dallas. Now Klingberg, another try. That's blocked by Bozak, and it goes into the netting.
Well, the Dallas Stars feeding off the power play situation, although the Blues doing a good job there on the penalty kill. And here's the pass by Klingberg, a potential UFA, right over there to Raffel, and he's trying to go against it there. And Fox just misses it. Maybe Scandella, who was diving first, might have caused him to take his eye off it, and then Parayko was nearby.
The other thing, Darren, that obviously that replay is in slow motion. That pass was pretty hard. So tough to tip.
Yep. I agree.
Now the star is a pass. Poked in by the Russian Radulov. All over Krug, a couple of 47s there. Now Radulov gets it wide open. Backhander, that goes wide. A Binnington. So the Stars an early push here in the second period. And a pass to the line. Secker cannot keep it in. And it goes all the way down. But Darren, as we know, the Blues in the second periods this year, their best period by far, plus 22 in goals scored this year in the second period. And so far, Dallas has had the edge in the second tonight, or today rather.
And it's Dallas's worst period.
That's picked off at center. Here's Brown. And his shot tipped off the glass. And then Sundqvist around back. Now on for Kostin. And then Brown. They go to work down low. Kostin a shot. That goes wide. Here's Parayko to the net. And that's covered. The tricky one in on Holtby.
Well, we showed you the slash that Ben gave Kostin in that first period. Well, Kostin comes in here. Ben's got it. And Kostin finishes his check, playing a good direct hockey game here. And he counters the physicality of Jamie Benn, takes a number, and goes at him on a good hit. That save by Braden Holtby. Just didn't look like he had full control of it, did John? He looked like he was kind of maybe looser in his pants. Looked like he was unsure.
Bit awkward. Now Mikula from the point. A shot. Tip maybe by O'Reilly. And that goes out of play. Let's pause now for this from Great Southern Bank.
How do you become number one? By focusing on what really matters. And what really matters to us is you. We're honored to be rated the number one bank in America by our customers, according to Forbes.
Shots 12-12, no scoring so far. On the faceoff, O'Reilly. Scramble draw, now picked up by Suter, who was signed as a free agent in the offseason after the Wild bottom out. Now grabbed again by the Blues captain. And right back in. It's Haskinen back in front of his own goal. On the wall, cut off by O'Reilly. Stars tip it out. Now Krug. And pinballs around now, back for Krug. And he looks around, finds Parayko. And then Pavel Buchnevich for Barbashev. And good checking there by the Stars. Turned away by Pavelski. Marco Scandella at the line. Bertuzzo, a little head fake. Now a shot up high, maybe off the mask of Holtby. Rebound was loose there for a moment. Now reverse to Haskinen. And the Finnish defenseman gets it onto Robertson. At the St. Louis line. Scandella there. Away from Fox, and now ahead for Thomas. Drops it for Shen with a move. Now Shen to the net for Cairo. He was open, but he never got the pass. And the puck is grabbed by the Stars. Raffles sends it in.
That all started with a great stretch pass by Marco Scandella. He's had a heck of a hockey game here.
Now Raffles again. That shot. Glendening with it. Backhander on goal. Saved by Binnington. Then he mops up the rebound attempt. 12:59 to go in the middle period. No score.
Air Force. Please welcome Staff Sergeant Sal and Joe Caruso, today's Boeing Home and Away military service members. They will be celebrating their 91st birthday next week. So once again, Blues fans, thank you, Sal and Joe Caruso, for your service.
Well, Sal and Joe Caruso are service members of the game. And, of course, they are the uncles of the Blues, Mike Caruso, who's been with the club since 89. VP of Communications, and I know Mike is very proud of his uncles, Joe and Sal, former Korean War veterans.
Man, if that doesn't get the heart pumping, what a great response by the crowd. Both teams on their feet, slapping their sticks. Great tribute to Joe and Sal, and thank them for their service for sure. And for putting up with Mike all those years.
Yes. I knew you'd add that.
Ah, we love old Mike Caruso, boy, and the whole family. Great people.
Yes, they are. 12:30 left here, second period. Blues and Stars scoreless. Peterson up the middle. Shot on goal. And a save by Binnington, now picked up by Mikkola. On to center Sundqvist. With Saad and Perron.
Dallas Stars are doing a great job coming back through the middle of the ice, taking away any potential board-to-board passes.
And Darren, right now a lot of one-and-dones for the Blues in the offensive zone.
Yeah, far too many. But, you know, give Dallas credit. They are a hard team to play against. They do a great job of getting out of their zone. But the Blues have got to find stronger sticks and put pucks into better place in the offensive zone.
Now Logan Brown. His mom and dad in attendance again today. Jeff up in the alumni box. And now Logan coming in. Krug pinches. Bozak per fault. Waits. Now shoots it. Block. Bozak. Another shot. Tipped just wide by Logan Brown.
Good hands there by Brown. That just missed on the stick side.
And filtered down the ice. Fault back to get it. Nice pass on for Brown. Good move by Logan Brown. Chopped away from him, and now it goes to Haskinen. And Dallas, a long pickup play to Podolski. The longtime Shark, spent 13 years in San Jose, a former seventh-round pick out of Wisconsin. Here come the Blues back with O'Reilly. And now Buchnevich into the Dallas zone. Here's Robertson for Podolski. With some room to Haskinen. He comes right in, back in front, wide open net. Save and the rebound, and they score. Robertson was there, and it's 1-0 Dallas.
You could hear that thud of that puck hitting the right pad of goaltender Jordan Binnington. But again, the Dallas Stars do a good job of getting out of their zone, get it up through the neutral zone, gaining the line. And right here, great play by Pavelski to play it over to Haskinen, who I thought he was going to shoot the puck. He doesn't, and there's that leaping in the air in celebration is Robertson. Let's from this angle here. Bang! Off the pad, and I thought, oh, I see what happened. The puck was actually lodged in the toe of the pad, and it crossed the goal line, although Jordan Binnington used his strength of his right leg to push the puck back out, but it looked like the puck was already in the net.
We will look at this as the referees will look at it. I believe it was in the net, Darren. We'll look at the replay again. And right there, about, you know, 2 inches across the line. So no question that will be a goal.
Yeah, this won't take long at all.
So referee Corey Sibret says it is a goal. Robertson gets his 12th. And the Stars lead 1-0. Here's Scandella back for the Blues. Two Bortuzzo. Long feed intended for Shen. Now gathered in by Hawkenpaw. Tipped by Kivi Ranta all the way down. It's Fox in there. And now Kivi Ranta. Checked there by Thomas. And Kyrou, look out. He dodges by a Dallas defender. And then Robert Thomas trying to follow up. Around back for Shen. Checked there by Hawkenpaw. Big hit by David Perron. Now it's centered. Kept in by Parayko. And then the Blues, Perron.
And Blues got to find that bite back right now. And I think Craig Berube's probably looking at some different options as well. He's always good at tweaking things if he doesn't find the right edge to the game. And clearly the Blues hadn't had that part of it just yet in a very tight checking hockey game.
Now the Blues have a break here. Sundqvist trying to squeeze down the boards. And he plays it around, but no one is home on the near wing. And taken over by Peterson. Youngster out of Sweden. And then dumped in by Esa Lindell. Sagan there for Dallas. In the deep slot, Gurion off-fisted. And now the Blues come back to center ice. Saad trying to make a play. The goal at 9:13. Robertson from Pavelski and Haskinen. And the Stars have broken the ice here. Now in front, wide open. Ben denied by Binnington. Oh, Jamie Benn, a great chance there. And remember that save, and the Blues chop it out.
Absolutely, all alone in front of the net, Jamie Benn. And he tries to bring it back to his feet and then go quickly high to the blocker side.
Now the Stars again. Binnington gets over, right pad is down, puck back of the goal. And now Ropey hints around Klingberg. And a stick comes up on Kost, and the puck's in the net. And Kostin got high-sticked a bit. And they will check for blood. As the Stars have picked up the first goal of today's game. Robertson is 12. It's 1-0.
Montgomery has a conversation there with Cliff Kostin looking at the iPad. Klingberg is in the penalty box, and I wasn't certain that it actually got him up in the eye area. It just barely clipped the top of the helmet. Kostin sells this like you read about right there.
Blues second power play today. At the line, Krug waiting. Now on to Perron in the circle. He dusted off. Now back to Krug. Perron again. O'Reilly one-timer. That's blocked by Glendening. And the Stars will play it down the ice. Their penalty killing this year, just under 80%, 19th in the league. As Krug drops it off for Perron. Now for O'Reilly. Good entry there by the Blues. Fed back to Schenn. And now the Blues get set up. Here's Krug for Perron. He waits. Seam pass wasn't there. Now O'Reilly gets it in front. Schenn wide open. Backdoor feed to Saad. Just missed. He was wide open. Now funneled back to Krug. Perron one-timer. Saved by Holpe. To the line again. Around now for Schenn. For Torrey Krug. Schenn lets it fly, and he missed up high and off the glass and back up.
Yeah, two great looks there from Braden Schenn. The first one, he tried that pass off to the far post right there, but nobody was aware of that. There's a lot of bodies in front. He might have had a chance to shoot that first one, but he sure got a lot on that second one, but it was high and wide.
Now the Blues in on the wing. Kyrou shoots it. That's off a stick. Off Haskinen and out of play.
Well, this we knew was going to be a battle between a great power play of the St. Louis Blues, third best in the NHL on both overall and home ice as well, against a penalty kill that has done a decent job. I mean, there's 19th in the National Hockey League, but there's some of the important numbers right there.
Now 43 left in the power play. Face off one, Kyrou, the shot, and he missed everything. Right off, a clean face off win. Darren, we mentioned the Blues' second period scoring. They have scored at least one goal in 15 straight second periods. That's quite a run. Trying to tie the game here. Tip back of the goal. And centered by Thomas, no one there. All the way back down. And now 15 left in the Klingberg minor. Dropped off to Buchnevich. Coming off a three-point effort. Now for Thomas.
Nice move.
Back to Falk. Back to Thomas. Looking low. Instead, back to Krug. Now for Kyrou. Klingberg is out of the box. Blues are 0 for 2. And they had one shot on that power play. As Jamie Benn gets the puck to the St. Louis line, but he waits a bit too long, and that is an offside. Well, don't miss your chance to see the newest NHL team, the Seattle Kraken. They come to town on Thursday at 7 o'clock. Game time 7 o'clock, as I said, and tickets are on sale and available at stlouisblues.com. The Kraken come to town, but we won't see our buddy Schwartzy, Darren. He had hand surgery the other day, so that's too bad for Jaden Schwartz.
Yeah, it is. We're looking forward to seeing him for sure. What time is the game, John?
I think I said 7, right?
I think it's 7 o'clock, John.
Yeah, and we're on the air at 6:30 on Bally Sports Midwest.
They got some beautiful sweaters. The Seattle Kraken.
I agree. Of course, they play their home games at Climate Pledge Arena. The Blues will be up there late in the month. Now Hakanpää for the Dallas Stars. And the big finish defenseman ahead. Now carried in by Peterson, right through the slot, and chipped away by David Perron. And Sekera back to get it. That may have hit Bortuzzo going off.
That sure did, right on the leg as he was over the boards.
Blues don't clear it. Here's Ben again, wide open. In front and a diving play by Mikkola to block that pass.
Once again, Binnington lost his stick.
And once again, Ben was wide open.
Yeah, he's going to be shaking his head. He's had a couple of glorious scoring chances in this hockey game.
Now Lindell around, kept in the slot. O'Reilly with it.
Oh.
Spins around on Gurionov. Now for Barbashev. And trying to bank it off the ankle of Holtby. Comes back to this side, kept in by Mikkola. And now Buchnevich there, trying to push the pile. And O'Reilly at the line.
No, he kept
it alive. Yanni Hockenpah around for Lindell. O'Reilly is all over him. Under five to play, second period. Blues down by one. Now Barbashev trying to find some space. And off Robert Thomas, and a diving Radulov pokes it down the ice. Here's Krug back to the Blues. And he took a high step. Maybe from Gurionov, and he's down. So it looks like back-to-back high-sticking minors against Dallas as Ben goes off.
High stick from Jamie Benn. Before that, Buchnevich comes in, leaves the ice surface on the skates, trying to get a hit in on Benn, and here's the minor penalty. You can see the stick of Benn slides up with one hand on his stick, and it goes underneath the visor and clips the left cheekbone of Tory Krug. A two-minute penalty and a huge time for the Blues that didn't get much going on that first power play of this period.
And 0-for-2 today with two shots. And that's off Kyrou and back out. And now the Stars' Glendening races in shorthanded and pushed off the puck by Justin Falk. And it's in the skates of Falk and Glendening. Finally, pride free by Thomas.
Good job by Glendening, just killing off seconds on the clock there.
Now Buchnevich, here's Kyrou. That shot goes high and wide. And it comes around now for Kyrou, who has points in his last four consecutive games. 9 points in the four. He gets it back across. Kyrou dusts it off again. Now Falk for Kyrou to Thomas. Saucer pass now settled in front of Barbashev. He missed it. But there's Kyrou at the line. Kept alive. Thomas coming in front of Barbashev. And that's poked wide. And now Lindell with time picks an opening, and it goes all the way down.
A little bit of a tough play there for Barbashev to be able to get a lot on that there, on his forehand, but not really on a strong side.
Now 50 left of the power play. Here's Perron ahead. Moved in by Krug. He's got some time to the line.
Look out here.
And blocked. And the Stars come back. Raffle 2-on-1. Short-handed a shot. And a save by Binnington. On Raffle.
Boy, did he hold his ground nicely. No movement whatsoever from Binnington. He took it on the right pad.
And O'Reilly coming back. Drops it off Perron. Leaves it for O'Reilly. Two Stars are there. And the Blues can't keep it alive. Now 15 to go in the Ben Minor. At the line, it's Saad. Now for Shen. Throws it across the ice. And that's knocked away by Arope Hintz. So Dallas doing a great job on the kill today. Against the third best power play. No shots on that power play. Stars still lead on the goal by Robertson.
In fact, the best opportunity was shorthanded by Raffel.
Now Haskin in a shot. That was blocked. And then Pavelski down low. Here comes Jamie Benn. He's been all over this game. Now Benn in front, backhander, and that goes just wide. And then Pavelski back of the goal. Checked there by Bozak off the boards and out. Now Suter ahead. Jason Robertson right back in. He has scored the only goal today. It's Parayko fanning on that. And the Blues don't move it down the ice. That's dropped back in the Blues zone. And now Binnington will cover for the whistle.
I don't think the Blues would be able to change it because that puck got covered up from distance there. And here's the shorthanded play right here by Raffel. He's going down the right side, and our Suntrip big saves. And that's what I'm talking about. Very limited movement there. Good angle being covered by the goaltender, Jordan Binnington, as this wrist shot comes back into his skates a little bit. Raffel, you know, is going to go to the opposite side. And clearly, Jordan Binnington reads that. Jamie Benn gets rest on the bench. He's been an impactful player in this game. He's got his fingerprints all over it. And could have two or three goals.
At least two. He's been wide open twice in cold turkey on Binnington. And the faceoff one back and a drive right on goal by Sekera. And again, a save by Binnington.
Good coverage there by Sundqvist on his man on the faceoff dot. And kind of a parting of the blue sea to allow the goaltender to see that shot by the veteran defenseman.
And Sundqvist wins it from Hintz. Now Falk ahead, tipped by Costin. Stars get it back. Broken up by Scandella. And now picked up by Falk. Here's Costin, 80 seconds left in the period, and the Blues are offside. And we are back after this from the Suntrip Automotive Group.
At BMW of West St. Louis, we have the most, so you'll save the most. Shop over 75 new BMWs, X3s, X5s, all ready for immediate delivery.
I think when the Blues get the puck, John, I think the message is going to be skate. Start skating with it and get it going north, even through the neutral zone. Don't wait to make a play. And by doing so, Costin ends up going offside.
And now the Stars ice it with 1:09 to go. They've also passed up a lot of shots there, and the Blues, 14 total shots in the game after racking up 10 in the first period. So only 4 in the second.
And that includes 2 power plays.
Right. Thomas on the faceoff. He wins it back, but the Stars jump in the hole and poke it out. Now Krug for Kyrou. Under a minute to go in the period. Klingberg back for Dallas. Peterson to center. Too far for Radulov. And now recovered by Shen. And then Krug feeds it back. Here's Falk, a long pass. Shen tips it to the corner. Thomas after it. Now it comes to Kyrou. Back to Krug. And goes back to Kyrou. And then a bouncing puck for Shen. Here's Thomas back to the goal. And checked by Peterson, then Thomas knocked him down, and he'll go to the box. He knew it right away.
Seconds left in the period, so if Dallas doesn't score now, they get a fresh sheet of ice to begin the third.
St. Louis, minor penalty. Slashing.
Slashing call on Thomas. Looked like Thomas was going to win the battle originally there, but Pedersen got in there, and Thomas comes over top of the hands and knocks it right out with some force.
So Dallas to the power play for the second time in the game. And the faceoff won by O'Reilly. Now it comes to the Blues captain. Tip to the line. And then a shot comes right in front. Hooked by Scandella. Right to O'Reilly, who whips it down the ice. And 10 to go in the period. And the veteran Suter, tipped by Jamie Benn into open ice. There's Sundqvist, long flipper back in there, and that will do it. So the period comes to an end, and the Dallas Stars skate off with a 1-0 lead, and they will have the power play for 1:35 to begin the third. Robertson has scored the only goal. Coming up next, it's the Jack in the Box second intermission report with Alexa and Bernie Federko. Blues being outshot 19-15 in the game. And after two, Dallas with a one. Robertson has the only goal, and the Dallas Stars take a 1-0 lead into the third period. This matinee, the Blues and Stars. Well, Derek Pang, the Blues need to do better than have 4 scoring chances and 15 shots through two periods. How do they do it in the third?
Well, the good news is they got 20 minutes to empty the tank and really go at the Dallas Stars that played yesterday afternoon, and they had to empty their gas tank because they trailed 2-0 but came back against a really good Pittsburgh Penguin team and won the game 3-2. But, I mean, clearly, Jamie Benn has been the most effective player on the ice for both teams at this particular point. I mean, the physicality part of it, and the Blues would like nothing more than to turn the tides here on Jamie Benn, the captain of the Dallas Stars, and get their game going. And obviously, two power plays didn't work very well. The Blues haven't generated a whole lot of speed or entry zone time. And of course, our Plaza Tire Service storyline is that number 14. Almost 12 minutes. Three slot shots. One of them he actually fumbled on it there. But he's had the best of the scoring chances by any individual in this game.
And 1:35 left in Robert Thomas's minor. So the Stars begin the third on the power play. Their record when leading after two is 10-1-1. The Blues win trailing 1-6. As John Klingberg waits in his own zone. Now Klingberg ahead for Hintz. He did tip it, no icing there. Binnington plays it back against the green. O'Reilly with a good play, now on to Sundqvist. He comes in one-on-one. Sundqvist shoots it up high, and a save by Holpe. Not a bad play by the Swede there.
No, not at all. A good play to bring that puck in and change the angle there so the stick doesn't deflect it.
Now Robertson on the right wing side. Radulov backdoor, Klingberg. Oh, Binnington got over and made a great save. And now Robertson again. Klingberg had a wide open net there. Now back to Robertson. On this Dallas man advantage. Rope hits, spun around. Klingberg to the front. Robertson a pass to Hintz, wide open. And a save by Binnington, who's lost his goal stick again. He grabs it though. Stars feed it back now to Klingberg. For Pavelski, slot pass to Hintz, to the net. Robertson was looking for the tip, but it was too hot. And now Radulov around. 20 to go in the power play. Good pressure by Dallas. Hintz. Radulov. Radulov gets it back. And now Robertson on the goal line. Klingberg unloads it. And that was off bodies in front. And the Blues with a chance to clear it. They don't. Hits with it. Shot. Saved by Binnington. And then Radulov after the rebound was tied up and Thomas is back.
All right, Radulov can't find the back of the net. Missed on an open one in the game yesterday afternoon. And there he was right on the doorstep again.
And the Blues get it back, and now Barbashev ahead for Buchnevich.
Oh,
he'll drop it off to Thomas. Now for Shen in the slot. A shot. That's blocked by Pavelski, and it goes into the netting. And we get a whistle.
Well, some great penalty killing there. Led largely by Jordan Binnington. And this one here, skate save by Mikkola, right on the doorstep to Hintz. Goes right off the 55 of Colton Parayko. And here's the one by Klingberg. It just explodes off his skate, but still Binnington had to be sharp getting that right pad down along the ice. This one was a low one. Radulov's on the doorstep, can't control that one. Binnington did a good job with a free stick right there. But you're right about Binnington. It's gotta be five times now that he's dropped that stick in the crease. Either something's bothering him with that, or there's other options maybe to grab it with the blocker. I'm not sure, but it doesn't happen that often in the game.
What are they using baseball? Stick them? Maybe you should get some of that, right, Darren?
It's a little football, little Fred Biletnikoff.
Oh, stolen by Shen. Wide open. Oh, what a save by Holpe. And that was the Blues' best chance. Shen in alone. And now in front, Kyrou. And he chips it wide at the line. Torrey Krug angles it back of the goal. Comes right in front and rifled around by Benn. But not out. Checked in by Krug. And now Shen. Had it knocked away. Kyrou trying to find David Perron. And the Stars lifted off the glass and back down. So a different look for the Blues on that last shift. And boy, did Shen have a great chance to tie the game. And now Brown to center ice.
Yep, and that gets Braden Shen back to the center ice position, one that he's the most comfortable at. And Shen gets a remarkable scoring chance right there. He has scored his 200th career goal that game in Pittsburgh. And now you see he's put some pressure on and steals it. A good read right there. And he see he goes to the glove side, and the goaltender is already leaning towards that way. See the way he's giving him that glove side and then taking it away with the pad. A little old school save there by Braden Holtby.
And the Stars off to face off. Holtby won his first seven career games against the Blues, but lately has lost two of three. Has not been overworked today, to say the least.
No, he gave up five in his last start, but he won 6-5 against Florida.
Now the Blues and Robert Thomas. Three Stars are back. He carries the mail into the zone. Sod there, chip back to Scandella. Fires one to the corner. Up the board, Parayko. That shot tip wide. And now Mikkola in from the line. Thomas getting free. Nice pass back. Parayko on for Sod. In front. Backhander on goal by Parayko, I believe. And now Thomas to Sod. And a one-timer goes wide. Brown, wide open net. Trying to stuff it in. And that was off a stick, and the Stars play it down the ice.
And again, Craig Berube pushing the right buttons. That change that he's made has sparked something offensively.
And now the Blues get the puck out. Not very far, though. Lindell lobs it back in. And Nico Mikkola away from Kiwi Ranta. And now Mikkola knocks Kiwi Ranta down. And then Vucinovic for O'Reilly. This line does stay intact. O'Reilly with the Russians. Now Barbashev. Vucinovic shot right on goal. And a save by Holtby. Another good chance for the Blues. And now Radulov. And a backhand clearing attempt goes down. Krug back to get it for the Blues. As both clubs make changes. Nearly 5 minutes gone in the third. Kyrou flies in. Can't cut through Lindell. Robertson gloves it down. Held in by Thomas. Now Kyrou trying to get away from Heiskanen. And then Heiskanen blocks his pass. Then shoots it high to the St. Louis line. And a tricky one there for Parayko. And he was knocked down by Pavelski. Now Parayko gets back up. Here's Falk back for Parayko.
Yeah, that other line combination, a bit of an aberration, maybe coming off the power play or the penalty kill, excuse me. But it looks like it's back together here with Shen on the left.
Now Thomas deep in his own zone, pass in front to his teammate Parayko. Kyrou down the wing. Shoots it high and wide. That rattles by Shen. Thomas kept it in. Now Shen, Kyrou in front, and the pass right by his blade. And he was in the goal crease. And it goes all the way back down. Stolen there by Tyler Seguin. Now for Ben at the line. Hockenpah lobs it back to the Blues goal. And the pass back. Ben can't hold it in. Bozak trying to get it as the goaltender Holtby chops it around. Good play by the Saskatchewan native. And then Hockenpah center ice. He's bumped into by Costin. Dumps it in. Krug with it.
With that line change by Dallas, Craig Berube saying, let's get her going here. Push it up the ice.
In the slot. A couple of bodies are there. And it's picked up by the Stars. Waffle. Dumped in off the glass and now caught by Binnington. So the Blues, a pretty good push early on. Four shots so far in this third period, a couple of great eight chances.
Slot shots after 40 minutes of play, and he gets a beauty right there. Nearly redirects it. Oh boy, he tries to pull it on the back end of the forehand. Hockenpah is right there, and it doesn't get on net. And there's a nice pass there by Ryan O'Reilly. That is a great slot opportunity by Vucinovic, and a better save by Braden Holtby.
And it stays 1-0 Dallas. The only goal by Robertson midway through the second period. Blues win the faceoff and walked along by Saw. Gets it in behind Lindell. Now for Perron. Trying to center one. And Sundquist there. And a good stick by Dallas to break it up and then lifted down by Hintz. And that should be an icing call. And it is. Well, support your favorite team on game day and every day with exclusive gear from STL Authentics. You'll find national brands, local vendors, and authentic Blues jerseys. Shop online now at STLAuthentics.com.
Some sharp look at a tire there, John.
is it ever. Thanks to our models, Saad and Jordan Kyrou. And a centering pass there by Lindell blocked. Now Krug, nice feet ahead. Here's Kyrou. As the ice opens up, in for Shen. Shen to Kyrou, fires it up, high rebound. What a save on the wraparound by Thomas. By Holtby.
He got his left pad on that. Great save there by Holtby.
And now Kyrou, bumped by Lindell. Stars get the puck ahead. Rack Fox gets it deep. And now Falk back. That's knocked away. Fox all over Kyrou. Long shot by Suter wide. Comes around to Miro Heiskanen, but it was knocked down with a high stick. And we get a whistle.
Ah, what a save by Holtby. Only 6-7-1 so far this year, but the first one off the angle, the second one, he manages to get himself back in the middle of the net after this play here. And amazingly so, because his side of his head looked like it hit Roope Hintz's shoulder pads, but yet he uses his angles, or his edges, excuse me, and then pushes to the middle where, I mean, if he doesn't do that, then it's in the net for sure.
Yeah, that was more of a skate save than a pad save, so... The Blues came close there to tying the game. Now Heiskanen, bothered in there by Saad, and the puck lifted out by Dallas. Rather, Barbashev was in the forecheck. Now the Blues with it. Handed on to Barbashev for Bortuzzo. Slaps it, and that goes wide. Puck was rolling. Scandella at the point. Kicked away by Radulov after he blocked the shot. Now Buchnevich winds up. Doesn't get by Ben. And now Jamie Benn back in. Waiting, now shooting one. That goes wide, comes around Sekera. And that wrist shot blocked by Barbashev. And then Torrey Krug a pass. That was tipped away. Now Justin Falk will try the other side. And he gets it out. And Falk off a stick, that goes wide. No icing here. Hawk and Pod drilled back of the goal by Sundqvist. And now it's Hawk and Paw for Dallas. And then fired in by Gurianov. Hitting 10 ahead on right wing for Perron. Now Saad has some speed. Hits the Dallas line. Chips it wide. Sundqvist comes in, knocks a man down. And now the puck covered there by Holtby. Well, here's your chance to get a piece of Winter Classic history. The Blues are auctioning off selected game-used items from the 2022 Winter Classic. Simply text BLUES to 76278. The auction begins Monday at 10 a.m. and closes on Thursday at 9 p.m. All proceeds benefit Blues for Kids.
That's all you should need to know. Goes to a great cause.
Helping a lot of kids. Off the faceoff, David Perron has it. Now Perron for Mikkola, backdoor! And he couldn't jam it in. And Dallas feeds it off Parayko and down. As Binnington sets the table for Parayko, he's thinking offense. Stripped of the puck at the line, and now it's Saad following up. Sundqvist to Parayko. And the Blues dump it in deep.
I don't think Parayko could believe that he had that puck stripped from him. I mean, he thought he was off to the races right in front of me here through the neutral zone.
Yeah, he was,
galloping
up the ice.
Yes, he was.
Like a Triple Crown winner, Darren Pang.
He is a thoroughbred.
Shen for Kyrou. Heiskanen getting back on him. And now Heiskanen up on the wing. Hintz hits Robertson at center ice. That's pushed the other way by Falk. Now Kyrou trying to get free. He does. In front to Shen. He waits, delays. Back in the slot. No one there. And now Krug. Fed back to Falk.
Uh-oh.
Checked by Ben. And he's got a break with Robertson. Now Ben waiting. Still waiting. To Suter a shot. And that was blocked. Maybe off his own man, Robertson. And now it is Shen all over Jamie Benn. Fed back to Heiskanen. That shot blocked by Falk, and the Blues get it after another odd man rush led by Jamie Benn. Here's Sagan down the wing. He's offside with 9:14 to go in regulation time. Stars still leading 1-0 here in St. Louis. Coming up on Monday, January 17th, the night you don't want to miss, the Blues will be celebrating Chris Pronger raising his number 44 into the Raptors during a special pregame ceremony starting at 6 o'clock. Plus, the first 12,000 fans receive a replica banner courtesy of Valley Sports Midwest. Visit stlouisblues.com and get your seats today.
What a combination of defense, meanness, to this
offense,
meanness, dirtiness,
leadership,
whatever it takes to win us.
Of course, a cup winner with Anaheim.
Yeah, absolutely. Love watching him and Chopper Al McGinnis on the points. Just phenomenal hockey sense there.
So the Blues still down 1-0 here. 8:45 left.
Did I say meanness?
Yeah, about five times. And O'Reilly gets the loose puck wide open. Krug, he comes in, shoots it off the glove and wide. Oh, Holtby, a great save there. Now center, Barbashev to Krug, right in, fires it on goal, and a save by Holtby. That's exactly where Krug scored from the other night.
Yeah, great job there by Buchnevich in front of the net too, and give the Dallas defenseman plenty of credit for boxing out and pushing to the outside. But that one there, I thought was in the glove of Braden Holtby. It must have glanced off the outside of the webbing. Great play there by Barbashev to draw three players towards him. But Ryan Suter still does a good job of boxing out. There's that first shot right there off the mitt. You can see that the goalie thinks he's got it in there as well.
What? Over? Did you say over? Nothing is over until
the Dallas Stars waited for as long as they could to make a line change. The referees came over to them now, but John, the Blues obviously don't want to put their guys on the ice. They have last change. Good tactic by Rick Bonus to buy a little time.
It is Shen, Kyrou, and Thomas. Shen wins the faceoff. Back to Parayko. And that shot blocked by Roope Hintz. And back out. Blues have not been shut out this year. Here comes Shen. That is fed all the way around. Kyrou settles it. In there with Thomas. A couple of Stars are after them. Pops Ray Robertson with it. And now Roope Hintz will nudge it down the ice.
Yeah, Hintz and Mikkola played on a World Junior Championship Finnish team that won gold in 2016.
Now it's Esa Lindell for the Dallas Stars. Pass up on this wing. And swatted in by Radulov. Bortuzzo there. And does a good job in the corner now for Perron. And Sundqvist gets free. And the backhand dumper. Duffin, rather. Sakurat checked. Now Perron with it. Off the side of the goal. Maybe off the arm of the goaltender. Scandella lets it rip. And a glove save by Holtby. Another good save with the glove.
Yeah, I don't mind that play by David Perron. The Blues are not a team that wastes shots on sharp angles just to funnel it there. But in a situation like this, he's on the goal line. He's waiting to see if the goalie is going to reverse VH. And we've seen so many goals like that where goaltenders just cheat off the post and you bank it right off the side of their mask or their back of their shoulder, actually. But Holtby did a good job of staying firm there.
The Blues 10 shots on goal in this period. 25 for the game. On the faceoff, Ben wins it from Sundqvist, but now the Blues get it. And Brandon Saad centers it. Good coverage there by Ben. And all the way back down. Here's Krug ahead.
Nice pass
for Saad. Spins, now back to the line, and drive by Falk, and fought off by Holtby. And Falk again. Funnels it all the way around. Tyler Seguin trying to chip it out. Good stick there by Perron. And toward the goal, now covered by Holtby and the Blues. Another face-off in the offensive zone.
Smart play there by Braden Holtby. Slow things down when you're on the road. And the Blues are putting on some pressure. Time now for a four-game summary. 6:43 left to go. Robertson with a goal and three helpers. We did that comparison with he and Jordan Kyrou earlier in the game, and David Perron now four shots on this in this game. And the Dallas Stars, John, have just called a timeout. That's a good call by Rick Bowness. It also allows the Blues to reorganize as well. But certainly, as you take a look at Robertson, boy, he's just a terrific player. So opportunistic. Getting some good goaltending from that guy.
Yeah, he has the only goal today. Darren, the Blues, we mentioned, in their last 11 at home, 10-0-1. They are averaging four goals a game at home this year.
Well, they've run into a pretty solid defensive team that's got some confidence. They're back-checking hard. I think Dallas is doing a good job of boxing out in front of their net as well. Big, sturdy defenseman that they have, and mobile defenseman. They come as advertised.
So after the timeout by Bowness, it's O'Reilly in on the faceoff against Foxa. One cleanly to Falk, a shot, and that goes high over the glove of Holtby. After a clean faceoff win by O'Reilly. Now four players battle for it. It's O'Reilly in front. Krug was there. Stars break it up, and they knock it off the boards. And now ahead to Foxa. He races in, shoots it on goal, saved by Binnington. And he bobbles that rebound, now covers it.
And Buchnevich comes right in there, and he stirs things up with Glenn Denning. Crowd is just waiting to erupt here at Enterprise Center. Lots of time left in this game, but it's obviously imperative that your goaltender makes saves like that that are from distance, but they're still not routine saves. And obviously that would suck the life out of everything here if that goes in the net. It does not. And there's the you're right about that bobbled cover-up right there. And Buchnevich doesn't like maybe a poke at that loose puck. Falk's already there, but Buchnevich, he comes in there. Foxa, Barbashev.
It has been an old-fashioned Central Division battle. Now Kyrou stole the puck. He races in to the net, a shot, and it's saved by Holtby. He's taken down, and we get a whistle.
Great second effort. Great second effort by Kyrou, and it just shows that speed kills. I mean, he has got an innate ability at a standstill position to giddy up and go. But here, he's got some momentum there, and he does a great job against Suter, who's handcuffed against the boards. And then Kyrou actually leans right into Heiskanen, and this is a powerful move by him. Look at the way he leans in, uses his left knee, protects himself from Heiskanen, and gets a good chance. Might have been able to even hold on to that, John, and go wide to the backhand. But at that point, he saw something that was available to him.
Thomas wins the faceoff. Now Mikola rolled around back. Thomas all over Foxa. Picked up by Heiskanen. Then thrown high. Darren, the Blues have shot a lot to upside on Holtby today. And he's had all the answers. Not sure if that's something they're trying to pick on or what, but boy, he's made a lot of glove saves. And now Kyrou back in. Can't get through the checking. Here's Mikola now for Kyrou again. Picked up by Parayko. He goes after it. In there against Heiskanen. Now centered by Thomas. Quick shot there. And it got through, and now Thomas again. Trying to duck under the checking of Sagan. Sagan, a good stick for Heiskanen. And now walked along by Ben. Here he comes. Jamie Ben waiting. That was blocked by Scandella. And then Ben drilled there, but Perron, I think, will take a penalty. Delayed call against the Blues. Lindella shot, saved by Binnington, and now the Blues touch it. And a tripping minor against the Blues. Down by a goal late in the third.
Number 57.
Go to the penalty box, trailing by one, only 5 minutes and 1 second left to go in the game, but that is the case. And you can see, here's what you're looking at right here on this side. This is David Perron going up against Jamie Benn. And I thought, well, maybe there's a slew foot in there, but there wasn't. He finishes his check. He does use his leg to, I think, brace himself or balance out the hit, but obviously knocks him down. The referee saw another angle, maybe more of a use of the legs than actually did happen.
And the back referee made the call, Darren. So Dallas on the power play, 0 for 2 with 4 shots. And a key time in the game with the Stars already up by 1. Radulov in front. Binnington, big save on Pavelski.
What a setup that was.
And it comes around now to Robertson, who scored the only goal today. Tip by Pavelski. Klingberg to hits. That shot blocked by Sundqvist. And then Radulov quickly around to the far side. Whipped back to the goal by Klingberg for the Russian Radulov. Chased by Bortuzzo. Now Pavelski trying to center one right back to little Joe Pavelski. Here's Klingberg out high. 45 gone on the power play. Klingberg gets it back. Long shot, lazy shot blocked by Scandella. And hammered ahead and down by Sundqvist. And the Blues make a change to their penalty killers.
Good start to the PK right there.
Now dropped off to Haskinen.
And a really good save by Binnington with that blocker on Joe Pavelski's one-timer.
Now Gurionov trying to get back in there. He does for Sagan. Spinning around. That's tipped by the Blues, and they get it. Short-handed chance now. And Robert Thomas checked from behind by Haskinen. That was nearly a two-on-one. And then Haskinen twists one back of the goal. Here's Sagan with it. And now he slows it down. On for Ben. Defers to Sagan. Now Ben with 25 to go in the power play. Sagan in the circle. Looking back door for Gurionov. That was off the mark. Now Suter with it. Trying to go to Haskinen, blocked by Mikula. And he pounds it down the ice. So a good kill by the Blues. And David Perron getting set to return. Ryan Suter ahead. Now for Raffle. Glendening shoots it on goal. Rebound. Binnington makes a couple of saves as Perron is back. And we get a whistle.
Good saves there by Binnington to keep this just a one-goal deficit. He's continuing the lifeline here for the Blues. Here, this shot, it was deflected off the tip of the blade by Raffle, and a good left pad save. And then the rebound's right there. And this is where you want to make sure that the defenseman just blocks him out. That was that save we're talking about on Pavelski. Pavelski thinks he's got him beat to the blocker's side. It was a great shot, just a better save. What a response.
So the Blues back at full strength. Dallas one shot on the power play. Under 3 minutes to go in regulation. Raffle away from Sundqvist. Killing time here. Now to the open side. There's Brandon Saad. Fires it up on right wing behind Perron. And the Stars get it out and they get it in. It's Parayko back to get it for the Blues. You never know if Ruby could pull the goalie at any point now with 2:25 left.
He's yelling at Binnington right now.
Here's Kyrou coming in. Shoots it. Back off a stick and wide. Binnington stays in for now at least. And the Stars shoot it down the ice. No icing.
The timing of pulling the goalie, it has to be perfect. There can't be any errors on the change for the players that are on the ice, whether they've got energy or not.
And now Kyrou gets it. Binnington is off. Empty net now for the Blues. Ben's pass blocked. Here's O'Reilly checked. And a penalty called against Jamie Benn. And a hooky minor with 1:52 to go.
Well, he said his fingerprints have been all over this game, and they certainly have.
Dallas number two-minute minor penalty for hooking.
So after those timely saves by Binnington in the Blues end, now a power play. Everyone thought it was Jamie Benn. It's not. It's Hockenpah that's going off to the penalty box. Let's keep our eye on it because Benn was there beside him.
Yeah, they both got the stick up. It's Hockenpah who goes.
Yeah, it wouldn't be a call on Ben. He lifted the stick, but Hockenpah got his with one hand on it. That long reach just got tangled up. Great break for the Blues here. Great break. The power play hasn't exactly been clicking, but all it takes is one shot. All you're worried about is tying the game.
0 for 3 today. Stars. Oh, they don't clear it.
Want to keep it.
Hit O'Reilly.
Oh, no.
And now they give it up, and an empty net fired wide by Raffles. The Blues a 6-on-4 advantage, trying to tie the game. And they drop it off to Shen. Now for Thomas. Hits the line. That pass tipped. It's O'Reilly losing it. Broken stick, though. Kyrou comes in. Right on goal, and a blocker save by Holpe.
Whose stick is broken?
Raffles. Look at his stick.
Yep.
And now Robert Thomas. Across for Kyrou. To Crew. Kyrou and Crew. They play catch. Kyrou again waiting. Down low in front to Shen. And he can't stop it by the pad of Holtby. In a minute to go here. He's getting knocked down. Blues get it back. And Kyrou out of the corner. In front. To O'Reilly. Mad scramble. A shot wide. O'Reilly. He scores. The captain has tied the game. Unbelievable.
After the Blues have a lot of territorial advantage right there, they don't get anything on the net. There's going to be a delayed minor penalty against the Dallas Stars, but instead Ryan O'Reilly bangs it home right on the doorstep after Braden Schenn was there with that puck actively coming off the end boards. And look at the reaction of the Blues bench. Jordan Binnington deserves a lot of credit here in the third, made some timely saves, giving O'Reilly and the Blues a chance. A lot of conversation here between the referees.
For slashing.
If you yet.
And a penalty has been called on Heiskanen. So the Blues back on the power play with a chance to take the lead.
This has been an animated conversation. Look at the passion of Rick Bowness right here. He can't believe it. And a turn of events here in this one. Here's the slash right there that breaks the stick of Kyrou, who plays the puck with a broken stick. May have been the main argument for the Dallas Stars. And then the shot off the boards and the rebound comes out so actively. And Ryan O'Reilly is able to play it. Now, the thing is about that slash on the stick. See, Jordan Kyrou was in the motion of playing the puck, and so it moved forward. And then once he realizes that it's broken, he did let go of it.
And that power play goal means the Gateway 100 dealers will donate $500 to grant the wishes of critically ill children. Blues on the power play in a 1-1 game now. Kyrou to Thomas, a shot blocked by Hockenpah. And the Blues get it back on the goal. Bucinavich now to Kyrou in front. They score!
The same turn of events that happened at Dallas yesterday afternoon against Pittsburgh. The Blues have turned the tide. Bending but never breaking in this game. And back-to-back power play goals. 28 seconds left to go in the game. A battle in the corner. Hockenpah pokes it around. It goes right to Kyrou. Kyrou plays it in front of the net. It goes off the Dallas Stars player and in the net. Keep your eye on the front of the net right here. Hockenpah skate, shin pad, and into the net. No chance for Holtby.
Two goals in 18 seconds. Kyrou with the go-ahead goal at 19:31. Off the faceoff. Now Holtby goes off. Dallas pulls the goalie. What a turnaround. Podolski there, lost it. Flipped out by O'Reilly, and then batted back in by Klingberg. And now the Blues get it, as they don't whistle it down. And O'Reilly at the empty net fires it wide. 5 seconds left. Klingberg a pass. Now to Hintz. And Saad breaks it up. And the Blues, what a win. Two late goals. And they win 2-1.
Wow. Don't go away ever. What a game. Look at that grin on the face of young, enthusiastic Jordan Kyrou. Just trying to put it to the front of the net. And he gets a gratuitous bounce off Hockenpah. Number one goaltender Jordan Binnington deserves an awful lot of credit in this game. And the Dallas Stars left this ice with a lot of emotion and anger.
As Kyrou gets a second game winner this year. And the Blues extend their point streak at home, now 11-0-1 in their last 12 games at Enterprise. But Darren, none as exciting as this one, my friend.
No, and you know, those 1-0 deficits, you're pushing, you're starting to find your game. I could feel the energy of the Blues bench and the positive reinforcement going on. No one got down on themselves, even though they didn't play their best game, but certainly a really exciting finish.
All right, Tom Calhoun, what are the stars today?
Three stars of today's game. Tonight's third star, stopping 24 of 25 shots, playing in goal for the Blues, number 50, Jordan Binnington. The game's second star, scoring one goal and playing it a forward for the Blues, number 90, the captain, Ryan O'Reilly. And today's first star, scoring the game-winning goal, playing it a forward for the Blues, number 25, Jordan Cairo.
Well, a great capacity crowd once again this afternoon here at Enterprise Center, and what a thrilling finish for everyone here on a Sunday afternoon. We are pleased to be joined by the number one star of the game, Jordan Kyrou, who's over to my right. Jordan, kind of had to hang with this game, I guess, bend but do not break, and that looks like that's exactly what happened in this game.
I mean, obviously it was a battle all game, and you know, it was great for us to come back there and finish it at the end.
The game-winning goal that you scored, the look on your face, because you're probably not expecting that to bounce off the leg of their defenseman and end up in the net.
Yeah, I mean, Butcher made a nice play around the net there, and you know, I kind of saw Tomer back door, so I was trying to go to him, and I just saw everyone yelling, so I started telling too.
Hey, before that, the two goals were scored, your goaltender on the PK, Jordan Binnington, made some outstanding saves for you.
Yeah, I was actually sitting on the bench, and I was thinking to myself, man, like, what a huge save by Binner there, you know, that kept us in the game, and you know, now we can go win it.
Well, Jordan, congratulations. Great work. This is an exciting afternoon for everyone.
Yeah, let's go.
Thank you.
An unbelievable afternoon. Bernie, back-to-back power play goals. That man right there, Jordan Kyrou, the hero in this one, our BJC difference maker. It's just the magic, the electricity of being here at home that this team loves.
Well, you just don't know what's going to happen in the game anymore. I think we saw the other night, the Blues, you play till the buzzer, and that's exactly it. The Blues scored a goal with less than a second left the other night against Washington. Well, tonight it took over, 59 minutes before they could score one, but they ended up scoring two. So, you know, these are the funny things that happened in the game. This one here, there was going to be a slashing call right there. I don't know why he threw his stick later on that one, but the puck comes off the end boards, comes right out underneath Holtby, and right Johnny on the spot there, you see O'Reilly, and then the game winner goes right off the skate there of Hockenbaugh. He was trying to actually just deflect that and ends up hitting the skate going in. So sometimes you get the breaks, other times you don't get the breaks, and Rick Bonus not happy. And I have to say this, I'm not, you know, surprised that he would do this, because to call a couple of power plays against you in the last minute of play, you don't see that happen very often, and Rick Bonus not very happy at all. And I think we always say this, though, you know what? In the course of an 82-game schedule, you're going to get good calls, you're going to get bad calls. And you know what? A lot of times we hear people complain about the refereeing, about the calls that are made. Well, you know what? You get calls at both ends of the ice. And I think that in the course of the year, I don't know if it evens out, but certainly I think the Blues got the better of the calls tonight, and you just don't know what can happen. But you have to capitalize. When you get the opportunity, you have to capitalize, and the Blues certainly were able to do that tonight. What an end to this hockey game.
A huge home victory here at Enterprise Center, giving the fans something to explode for when they got up out of their seats for the final minutes of this one. We got plenty more coming up on our post-game show.